Joining us now is Elizabeth Esty. She's the congresswoman who represents Newtown, Connecticut. Congresswoman Esty, thank you so much for being here tonight. I really appreciate your time.
Thanks, Rachel. Glad to be here.
We spoke on this show before the Connecticut State Legislature had moved to pass new gun laws in your state. Now, your governor has signed those new laws into effect. Are you satisfied with what your state has done? Do you think this was the right package of reforms?
I do think it's a great package of reforms. And one of the things that's so heartening about it is that here in Connecticut, which is quite frankly, and you've talked about it, it's a big gun state. This is the home of arms manufacturing in the United States. It's part of our history. My district in particular is full of gun owners, of hunters, of sportsmen. And in this state, we got bipartisan cooperation to pass a very strong gun safety law that has the elements I would like to see in Washington. Banning of assault weapons, banning of high-capacity magazines, vigorous mental health program, and really looking at what we can do across the board with universal criminal background checks, really the foundation of what we must have at the national level.
On that issue of extended magazines, because I highlighted that in the introduction, and because we've seen the NRA's arguments on this issue sort of devolve, I think, as more states act to limit high-capacity magazines. How do you think Connecticut was able to get bipartisan agreement on that? I mean, obviously, Connecticut Democrats could have moved forward without Republicans at all. They have the numerical advantage in both houses of the state legislature, and there's a Democratic governor. But they were able to get Republicans on board for a bipartisan measure, bipartisan support, for that in particular. Is that duplicable in other states or maybe even federally?
Well, I hope so. And I think some of it comes from really knowing these people. They understand the cost of political inaction, and a number of the Republicans who voted for this bill knew some of the families in Newtown. And how could they look these people in the eye? And as you mentioned in your introduction, 11 children escaped out of that classroom when Adam Lanza was changing magazines. 11 lives were saved by the real life example of what happens when you run out of bullets in a magazine and in a chamber. It has real life consequences. And so how could those legislators who knew those families look them in the eye and say, I'm not doing everything I possibly can to save another family, another community from this sort of heartache?
The clip that I played of the one Newtown mom in the introduction there, one of the things that she said yesterday at the bill signing is that she feels like the families who have chosen to be advocates on this, and of course not all of them have, but the families that have chosen to ask for public policy reform in response to what happened to them, they feel like they have been treated with respect. They feel like they have been heard. They feel like they have been listened to. It's very heartening to hear that for a country that is very emotionally tied up in those families and what they've gone through. When you have been working with them, when you've been working with the Newtown survivors and people in that town, which you represent, do you feel like that's broadly held, that people feel like they are being heard, they are being respected, both in Connecticut but also nationally?
Well, I think, again, when you get people to focus back on core principles, how can we better care for our children? How can we reduce the number of gun deaths in this country? When you look at the fact of 30,000 people lost every year, over half of them suicides, there's almost no one in this country who doesn't know someone who was killed by a gun. And when you get people into a problem-solving mode, think, what can you do? What can we do? What can we as Americans do together to protect our children, to protect our communities? Then we stop the demonizing. I've been able to engage a lot of gun owners in my district who are highly supportive, particularly around universal criminal background checks for all sales and around federal felonies, stiff felonies for trafficking and straw purchasing. They know those are essential tools for law enforcement. And face it, Rachel, if we are going to keep guns out of the hands of criminals, we have to ask who these people are when they're buying guns. It's just common sense.
Congresswoman Elizabeth Esty, Democrat of Connecticut, when you were elected, did not know this would be such a focus of your time in Congress, I'm sure, but you've taken this up with as much alacrity as I think anybody could have ever expected. Thank you very much for keeping us apprised of what you're doing. Thanks very much.
Thank you, and thank you for your commitment to continuing to bring this issue in front of the American people. It really helps. Thank you so much.
Thank you. All right. Good news.